Hello and welcome to the video. Today's video is all about fonts in SvelteKit. I'm going to show you the two best ways that you can add fonts to your SvelteKit project. One way by using a project called FontSource, and the second way by using any font that you can download. I'm also going to show you how you can optimize these fonts in a similar way to other frameworks like Next.js, for example, by adding preload tags to your HTML so that the fonts load extra quickly. And finally, I'm going to show you a common way that people add fonts, but that actually has a bunch of problems and why you probably shouldn't be using it. Let's get on with the video. So I'm starting out here with a project that I just created. I literally just ran the new SV CLI and I got this new project set up. It is just the minimal template that we're going to be starting from. And we're going to customize this by adding some fonts. And now the first way that I really like to add fonts is to use this package called FontSource. And FontSource basically mirrors, I think, all Google fonts, maybe also other fonts. And they basically have little NPM packages for all the different kinds of fonts. So let's pick a font where we can like clearly see that it works. And that's going to be very different from the sort of default font. Let's maybe pick this one here. This one called Permanent Marker. And so what you can do here, once you are on the website for FontSource, you can click install here, and it's going to tell you how to install this as a NPM package. Let's go ahead and do that and see how we can make this work with SvelteKit. So I'll start by installing it. I will add the D flag, the development flag, because in SvelteKit, long story short, but all of your dependencies get bundled, so you actually can install most of your dependencies as dev dependencies, but we're not going to go into that today. I got the font installed. And you might ask, like, oh, how do I use it now? Well, it's so simple. Let's start by creating a layout. And since we're using Svelte 5, the way you add the slot in the layout is a little bit different. So let me go ahead and just borrow this example layout from the doc. So instead of doing slot, you do render children. And then you have children that passed as a prop. So I'm just going to do this. And this is actually perfect because we're going to create a couple of different routes. We're going to have one route that we're going to call FontSource. And then we're going to have another route, which is going to call local fonts, that I'm going to show you right after this. So let me go ahead and do that. Save the layout. Let's see that it still works. Here we go. We have our little menu. And let's now actually use FontSource. And it couldn't be simpler. It's literally just what it says here. You just import the package that you just installed. So let me go ahead and do that. There we go. Now the fonts are loaded, but we still, of course, need to specify the font family, which we're going to do here. So I'm going to go ahead and add a style tag here. Because we use the layout to load the fonts, they're going to be available to all of the routes inside the layout, including this page route. And let's just go ahead and change the font of the welcome to SvelteKit text and see how that turns out. There we go. Beautiful. That's literally all we needed to do to get any Google font working. And the best thing about the solution is that it's all local. So you install the font locally and you never contact Google service and you never contact any external service at all. It's all hosted with your project. So that's perfect. So that's if you have a font that you want to use that is available on Google Fonts. But what if you want to use any font, right? So let's tackle that. Let's go to this local fonts page. Let's create the route. I'm going to go ahead and create a route called local here. Fontspage.svelte. I'm going to copy it from the other route and just create a different route. So we have one route here, which is called FontSource, and one called local font where we haven't applied anything yet. So now let's see how we can use local fonts. And first of all, we need to download some local fonts. And luckily, you can actually download some local fonts from here. So I'm going to use FontSource fonts just for the demo, but you can use any font you want in any format, TrueType, WOF, whatever. I'm going to pick a different font, this Indie Flower one. And instead of installing it, I'm just going to press the download button, which is going to provide it to me as a zip file. And might be a tiny bit small here, but once I open it, I will have both the TrueType format and the web fonts format. Let's me for this demo just use the TrueType version. I should go into my project, and somewhere in the lib folder I can simply place the font. Let me go ahead and just place it in this lib font fonts folder. So when we used FontSource, FontSource was setting up everything. It was setting up the font family for us, the definition of the font name. But since we're now using a local font, we have to provide that ourselves. Luckily, FontSource does have some examples that we can use for this. I believe it's here in the advanced column. We can sort of get a kind of like an example font face to use, which is very convenient because we can use that to set up our font face. So let me go ahead and copy the font face definition here. Now, we could do this really anywhere. We could do this in the layout as well. In fact, let's move it to the layout just to keep the consistency. I will go to the layout here and I will create a style tag. Paste this in. We're not gonna bother with the Unicode ranges and stuff here. There we go. And we're only gonna handle the TrueType format. So let me go ahead and delete this. And so what we can do here, which is so, so cool, is that in this URL field, we can literally just point it to an import path within our project. And we can use the Vite aliases that SvelteKit set up. So we can simply do lib fonts and then the name of the font. Here we go. So now we've registered the font. Obviously, we have to keep track of the stuff like the font style and the weight ourselves, but that seems to match now with the default settings. And now in the page, I can go ahead and do this. And I believe this is the correct font family. Yes. And when I save this now and check how it looks locally, there we go. Now we can switch between these two different versions. We got one font coming from the font source package, and we have the second font coming from a local font file that we just added to our project without any packages or anything. There is one thing more that I was told you that I was going to show you, and that is how to optimize these fonts by adding a preload tag. Some frameworks do this by default. They help you with this. SvelteKit doesn't do it yet, but it is fairly easy to add, and I'm going to show you how you can do that. And what we need to do is to customize the handle hook that SvelteKit provides. And I'm going to just go ahead and I'm going to borrow the example code here that they have in the handle. And I'm going to create this file called hooks.server.ts under the source folder. Paste the example in. We don't need this custom route that they show as an example here. And we need to add one thing, which is we need to add a parameter to this resolve function. So if we look in the docs, there is this parameter called preload. Now, it is not fantastically well documented, or rather there's no like example that shows you how to use it. I will add a link in this video to a repo that shows you exactly how you should use this, how you should add this hook, so that you can just copy paste it into your project and be done with it. But the way it works is that you pass a second parameter to the resolve function here, and it's called preload. And this parameter takes a function that basically tells, I think it tells Vite, which types of resources to preload. And it has some sort of default, but you need to add the type font to it. So what we need to do here is we need to say type font or type JS or type CSS. And that's it. That's all you need to do. And if you have like already a custom hooks set up, it's very easy to add just this thing using this really handy function called sequence. And sequence, basically, it allows you to chain multiple of these kind of like handle hook middlewares together. So you just put sequence, and then maybe you have like some course handling and some login handling, and then maybe this fonts stuff. Now, when you add this, and we take a look at the output, it's actually not going to change, because I think this is some sort of magic that happens in the sort of build step. So what we're going to do instead is we're going to build the project and preview it so we can see how it would look in production with all of these changes. Let's go ahead and do that. All right, so I'm running the preview server now. I'm gonna go to the port 4173, which is the preview port, and just verifying here that everything still works. The font still loads, both the font source one and the local one. And now let's look at the page source. And what we will find here is that we have these tags here, link, rel, preload, and then it's going to include both of the two fonts we added. So because we added them in the same layout, they both get added. And I think it doesn't matter where, at which depth you add the fonts, they should all be added here to the head to be preloaded. And here we have the first font we added from font source, this one called permanent marker. And then we have the second font that we added manually ourselves called indie flower. And that's it. That's really all you need to know about fonts. Now, I did say I was going to show you one way that maybe isn't so good to use fonts, and that is to use the static folder. So theoretically, you can just do the same thing as we kind of did here with lib, where we would like paste this font in here into the static folder. And then instead of doing like this nice lib stuff, we would just go, you know, slash like this. And I think this works, and maybe this is even the primary way, or the initial way that some people might try this. Yeah, so you see that works fine as well. We did get that little flash of unstyled content, which is might be one of the downsides of this approach. But the big downside with this approach is that one, you have no versioning control of this font. So when you import it with Vite kind of keeps track of the file. If it changes, it will change the file's name to kind of make sure that it gets cache busted for you. And the second problem with this approach of using the static folder is that we no longer have access to this nice automatic preloading ability that we implemented using the handle hook. So for those two reasons, I really don't recommend to use this approach. Instead, use the font source approach, or if you have any font that is outside of the font source library, use the local font approach where you just place the fonts into the lib folder. All right, that wraps it up for today's video. I really hope you liked it. If you have some thoughts about this, if you have any other ways to add fonts that I don't know about, please let me know in the comments. If you have ideas for future videos, I would love to hear them. And finally, if you like the video, press the like button and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.